بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن والاه، أما بعد، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. اللهم انفعنا بما علمتنا وعلمنا ما ينفعنا وارزقنا علما تنفعنا به، آمين رب العالمين. الحمد لله. We have hadith number 102 and 103 tonight, inshallah ta'ala. 102 is reported by أبو عبد الله حذيفة بن اليمان رضي الله عنهما قال صليت مع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ذات ليلة فافتتح البقرة. He says, I prayed with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم one night and he began with سورة البقرة. So حذيفة بن اليمان is reporting to us that he prayed one night قيام الليل, the night prayers behind or with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he started off with Surah Al-Baqarah, Surah Fatiha obviously, and then he recited Surah Al-Baqarah. فَقُلْتُ يَرْكَعُ عِنْدَ الْمِئَةِ. I said to myself, he will make ruku' after 100 ayat. ثُمَّ مَضَى, but he went on. فَقُلْتُ يُصَلِّ بِهَا فِي رَكْعَةِ فَمَضَى. I said to myself, perhaps he will complete the surah in one rak'ah. فَمَضَى, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم continued. فَقُلْتُ يَرْكَعُ بِهَا ثُمَّ افْتَتَحَ النِّسَاءُ أو النِّسَاءَ فَقَرَأَهَا. After Baqarah, he started Surah Al-Nisa and he recited it. Then he recited ثُمَّ افْتَتَحَ آلَ عِمْرَان فَقَرَأَهَا. He recited Surah آلَ عِمْرَان and he completed it. يَقْرَأُ مُتَرَسِّلًا. He recited slowly without any haste or speed. إذا مر بآية فيها تسبيح سبحة. If he came across any verse of the Quran wherein there was tasbih, any mention of Allah's greatness, glorifying Allah, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم would make tasbih. وإذا مر بسؤال سأل. If he came across any ayah that mentioned a question, asking Allah for something, he would stop and ask Allah. وإذا مر بتعوذ تعوذ. If he came across any ayah wherein there was seeking Allah's protection, he would stop and seek protection from Allah. ثم ركع. Then he made ركوع. So he recited Baqarah, Nisa and Al Imran in one raka'ah of Qiyamul Layl, reciting slowly and making dua and tasbih between the verses. ثم ركع. Then he made ركوع. So this is more than five ajza of the Quran, more than five juz. فجعل يقول سبحان ربي العظيم. And he would say سبحان ربي العظيم in the ركوع. فكان ركوعه نحو من قيامه. But his ركوع was similar to his standing. حذيفة says his ركوع was almost as long as his standing. ثم قال سمع الله لمن حمده. He said سمع الله لمن حمده. ثم قام. He stood up. قياما طويلا, a long standing, قريبا مما ركع, similar to how long he was in ركوع. ثم سجد. He made سجود. فقال سبحان ربي الأعلى. And he would say سبحان ربي الأعلى. فكان سجوده قريبا من قيامه. And his سجود was almost as long as his standing. This hadith is in صحيح مسلم. This was the mujahada of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is why the author obviously brings this hadith into the chapter of striving. This is how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam strove. We spoke about similar hadith of how his feet would swell because of how long he stood. And he would say, because I love to be a grateful slave unto Allah azza wa jalla. This is why he did it. So this is the virtue of standing in the night prayers and standing at length. Lengthening your night prayers. This was the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There's a couple of benefits that we can derive from this hadith. Number one is the reason the author brought it in, to show us how we should be striving as worshippers of Allah. Strive. Try to take out time and effort in the path of Allah. Even if it's in just between you and Allah azza wa jal, do this. Allah Azza wa Jal described the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Sahaba, and he said, "Tarahum ruk'an sujjada yabtaghuna fadlan min Allah wa ridwana." You see them, the Sahaba, the Prophets, you see them bowing, prostrating in prayer. seeking Allah's bounty and His pleasure. From the benefits of this is, when we pray the Qiyam prayer, make dua in between. If you understand the verse talking about Jannah, ask Allah for Jannah. If you understand the verses warning about Jahannam, ask Allah to protect you from the fire. You understand Allah is talking about His greatness, say Allahu Akbar. You see a verse talking about يُسَبِّحُ لِلَّهِ مَا Allah is glorifying Himself. Make say Subhanallah. Stop and say Subhanallah. Subhana Rabbi al-Azim. Subhana Rabbi al-A'la. Glorify Allah. This is how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did it. And he would thus combine in his prayer, recitation, focusing on the understanding of meanings, making dua, making dhikr. All of this was part of his qiyam. It was not just standing in front of Allah. Another benefit of this hadith, it's permissible to read a different tartib to the tartib of the Quran. I mean, surahs are in a sequence. In this hadith, what did the Prophet ﷺ do? He read Surah Nisa before Surah Al-Imran. Yet the order of the Quran is Al-Imran comes before Nisa. So if someone were to do this, this is permissible. For example, if I recited in the Salah, قُلْ أَعْضُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ in the first rak'ah, and then قُلْ وَاللَّهُ أَحَدٍ in the second, this would be permissible. Because the Prophet ﷺ did this at times. Although it's best to stick to the sequence. طيب, another benefit of this hadith is that it is permissible at times to pray Qiyamul Layl in Jama'ah. At times to pray Qiyamul Layl in Jama'ah, as we see the Prophet ﷺ did here with Hudhaifah. Another hadith with Ibn Mas'ud. Another hadith Ibn Abbas, and so forth. However, this was not the custom. This was not the norm. This only happened in Ramadan. The only time they prayed Qiyam together, daily, Ramadan. Outside of Ramadan, they did not come together to pray Qiyamul Layl. There was no announcement to say, we're going to have Qiyamul Layl programs. There was no such thing as, these days you see things like, we're going to have a Qiyam program for the people of Gaza. This is not the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ or the Sahaba, and this should not be done. This should not be done, because it's going against the Sunnah. They did it at times, and some scholars mentioned they did it by accident. Yani, Ibn Abbas would see the Prophet praying and then join him. They didn't intentionally come together to pray Qiyam together. Wallahu A'lam. The next hadith, I'm just going to read it because it's basically attached to this hadith, is from Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu. He says, I prayed with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam one night and he lengthened the prayer so much, أطال القيام حتى هممت بأمر سوء, until I felt I intended something evil. قيل, they said to him, وما هممت به, what was this evil thing that you intended or thought of? He said, هممت أن أجلس وأدعه, متفق عليه. He said, I intended to leave off the prayer and sit down because it was so long. He felt this was, you know, a bad thing that he was intending. But the point of the hadith is to show how long the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's qiyam was. So these are our two hadith for the night. There's some fiqh we've benefited from it in terms of fiqh issues. And of course, we learn about the mujahada of our imam. Our qudwatun hasana, the perfect role model, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Let us take a piece of it. We're not going to stand as long as he did, but we can try to stand at least every now and then, you know, exert yourself. Feel a bit tired in your qiyam. This is the idea behind qiyamul layl. Said you feel a bit of tiredness in your legs, a bit of tiredness in your body, but the rewards for this will be magnified. Wallahu a'lam wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.